Hello friends, this is your Vishal sir from Ikra School. Today I am here to explain chapter 1 of science, chemical reactions and equations from NCERT syllabus for class 10. Let's begin with the changes in chemistry. Basically you find two types of changes in chemistry. Physical change and chemical change. A physical change refers to a change in which molecules are rearranged but their internal composition remains same. The chemical change is a process in which substance transforms into a new substance having different chemical compositions. If you could not understand the definition, let's go through the examples. The tearing of paper, melting or freezing of water and cutting of trees are physical change. While burning of wood, trees, paper, rusting of iron, setting of curd, etc. is a chemical change. If you still could not understand physical change and a chemical change, go through this example. In the first thing that you find is chopping of wood, where wood is chopped into half, but it still remains the wood. That's a physical change. In the second example, you can see that the wood is burned. While burning, the wood becomes charcoal. It isn't the wood anymore. That is a chemical change. All these changes are chemical. A chemical change is followed by a chemical reaction. And a chemical reaction can be explained by an example. Let's take this example, burning magnesium strip. When the magnesium strip is burned, it burns with a dazzling flame, which changes to magnesium oxide. That is a totally different material. As you know, magnesium is a highly reactive metal. If brought near a flame, it burns with flame. The product that one obtains after its combustion is magnesium oxide, a completely new material than its original reactant. It is also to be noted that one cannot regain magnesium from magnesium oxide. This is an irreversible change. That is a chemical change. There are certain points which shows that a chemical change has taken place, like change in state, change in color, evolution of a gas, and change in temperature. These four points states us that a chemical change has taken place. The chemical change could be understood with a chemical equation. You need to find the shorter way or the simpler way of understanding chemical equation. The example that you saw just now was burning of magnesium strip, which produces magnesium oxide. If you want to make this understand in a writing form, it is not easy to say the statement every time. Let's take, how can you say about this? Magnesium plus oxygen gives magnesium oxide. That is the burning of magnesium strip, which reacts with oxygen to form magnesium oxide. But this is also a raw format of explaining. Let's go through the formulas that you have studied in standard 9. Instead of magnesium, we may write Mg as its molecular formula, for oxygen O2, and MgO for magnesium oxide. That is a chemical equation. But the chemical equation over you see has two parts. One part on the left side of the arrow and the other part on the right side of the arrow. On the left side of the arrow, you find Mg and O2. Those are called reactants. While on the right side of the arrow, you will find MgO. That is a product. In reactant, if you watch carefully, there are two atoms of oxygen, while there is one atom of oxygen in the product, which signifies the imbalance in the equation, which also does not conserve the law of conservation of mass. We need to balance the equation. The equation can be balanced like this, by putting amount of atoms before or the amount of numbers before the equation. Because we needed 2 oxygen, we implied 2 in front of MgO, that makes 2O in product also. But that also creates imbalance with magnesium. So for balancing that, we need to put 2Mg in the reactant also. This type of equation is called balance equation. The thing that we have studied in this chemical equations are, this is called chemical reaction, a word equation, a scale equation, and a balanced equation. Now let's go through the chemical reactions that you are going to study in your syllabus. The chemical reaction according to your syllabus are combination, decomposition, displacement, double displacement, oxidation and reduction. Now let's understand combination reaction. The combination reaction, the word itself says combine, when two or more reactants combine together to form a single product is called combination reaction. Go through the example. First example, carbon reacts with oxygen to give carbon dioxide. Hydrogen reacts with oxygen to form water. In both the examples, you can see the reactants combine together to form a single product. This type of reactions are called combination reaction. Decomposition reaction. In decomposition reaction, the simpler reactant, that means a single reactant, breaks down to give two or more products. The example is silver chloride kept in sunlight, silver and chloride decomposes. Same way, calcium carbonate decomposes to calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Chemical reactions number 3, displacement. Reaction in which more reactive element displaces less reactive element. Here you should notice that the elements given to you are of variable reactivity. Iron, when kept in copper sulfate solution, which is a bluish color, it forms after some time reddish brown color with iron sulfate, and copper is released. Iron, which is highly reactive, then copper displaces copper and forms iron sulfate. So this type of reactions are called displacement reaction. Double displacement reaction. Here also displacement takes place, but not of high reactive element to less reactive element. Instead, you can say like this, that there is ionic exchange of compounds in the reactant. You can understand that better from the example. Sodium sulfate, when reacted with barium fluoride, sodium, which is a positive ion, and barium, which is also a positive ion, displaces each other, forming barium sulfate and sodium chloride. So there is the exchange of ions between the two compounds. This is called double displacement. Now let's go through another chemical reactions. Oxidation. The reaction in which oxygen is added or hydrogen is removed is called oxidation reaction. You can understand that better with this. Copper, when oxidized, becomes copper oxide. Here you can see oxygen is being added to copper. So that's why it is called oxidation reaction. Let's go through the opposite of oxidation, that is reduction reaction. The reaction in which hydrogen is added or oxygen is removed is called reduction reaction. Example over here would be when copper oxide reacts with hydrogen, oxygen which was with copper releases from copper oxide and forms water over there. So hydrogen is added as well as oxygen is removed in reduction reaction. Oxygen is removed from copper oxide. This is reduction reaction. But if you watch carefully, oxygen which was the part of copper in the reactant is added to hydrogen in the product. So oxygen is added to hydrogen. When oxygen is added to hydrogen, you can say oxidation has taken place. So here oxidation and reduction both has occurred. This can also be explained as redox reaction, where oxidation and reduction, both reaction has taken place at the same time. Now let's revise what you have studied in this video. Number one, how is chemical change different from physical change? State any one main point. What is a chemical reaction? How are chemical equation written in different form? How many types of chemical reactions have you studied in this presentation? What differs displacement reaction from double displacement reaction? You will get all the answers from the slides that you have just gone through. Thanks for studying with us on this online session. Signing off, this is Vishal sir, your science teacher at ICRA High School, Surat. Thank you.